Yeah. We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 39, entitled Akrura's Vision.
今天我们学习博迦瓦坛第十篇三十九章，标题阿库拉看到的景象。
Text number
22,
第二十二节。
Nananda Sunu,
Nananda Sunu,
Shanna Banga,
Shanna Banga,
Soreda,
Soreda,
Samikshatena,
Samikshatena,
Swakritatura,
Swakritatura,
Bata,
Bata,
Vihaya,
Vihaya,
Gehan,
Gehan,
Swajanan,
Swajanan,
Sutan,
Sutan.
Tadashyam,
Tadashyam,
Adhopagata,
Adhopagata,
Navapriya,
Navapriya,
Nananda Suno Shanabanga Soreda,
Nananda Suno Shanabanga Soreda,
Samikshatena Swakrita Turabata,
Samikshatena Swakrita Turabata.
Vihaya Gehan Swajanam Sutam Patim
Vihaya Gehan Swajanam Sutam Patim
Tadashya Madho Bhagata Navapriya
Tadashya Madho Bhagata Navapriya
Nananda Sunu Shanabanga Soreda
Nananda Sunu Shanabanga
Samikshate na swakrita turabhata
Samikshate na swakrita turabhata
Vihaya gehan swajanam sutam patim
Vihaya gehan swajanam sutam patim
Tadashya mado bhagata navapriya
Tadashya mado bhagata navapriya
Sunu Shanabanga Soreda
Nananda Sunu Shanabanga
Soreda Samikshate na Swakrita Turabhata
Samikshate na Swakrita Turabhata
Vihaya Gehan Swajanan Sutan Patim
Vihaya Gehan Swajanan Sutan Patim
Tadashya mado bhagata navapriya
Tadashya mado bhagata navapriya
Nananda suno sana bhanga saurida
Nananda suno sana bhanga saurida
Sami satina swakrita turabhata
Sami satina swakrita turabhataVihaya Gehan Swajanan Sutan Patim
Tadashyam Adho Bhagata Navapriya
Tadashyam Adho Bhagata Navapriya
Nananda Suno Shanabanga Saurida
Nananda Suno Shanabanga Saurida
SamiSatena Swakrita Turabhata
SamiSatena Swakrita Turabhata
Vihaya Gehan Swajanam Sutam Patim
Vihaya Gehan Swajanam Sutam Patim
Tadashyam Adho Bhagata Navapriya
TadashyamNananda Suno Shanabanga Soreda
Samikshatena Swakrita Turabhata
Samikshatena Swakrita Turabhata
Nanda's son, who breaks loving friendships in a second, will not even look directly at us. Forcibly brought under his control, we abandon our homes, relatives, children, and husbands just to serve him, but he is always looking for new lovers.
甚至都不会正眼看我们，他们被他强行控制后，为侍奉他而抛弃了我们的家庭、亲戚、孩子和丈夫，但他却总是在找寻新的爱人。There's
no purport. We'll read the next verse.
没要旨，读下一个。23.
The dawn following this night will certainly be auspicious for the women of Mathura. All their hopes will now be fulfilled.For as the Lord of Braja enters their city, they will be able to drink from his face the nectar of the smile emanating from the corners of his eyes.
译文：今晚过后的黎明，对马苏拉的女人来说无疑是吉祥的。她们所有希望现在都得以实现，因为随着布拉加的至尊主进入他们的城市，他们就能合饮到他脸上透过眼角流露出的微笑的甘露了。
24. O Gopis, although our Mukunda is intelligent and very obedient to his parents, once he has fallen under the spell of the honey-sweet words of the women of Mathura and been enchanted by their alluring shy smiles, how will he ever return to us unsophisticated village girls?
牧牛姑娘们啊， 尽管我们的母昆达很明智，而且很孝顺他的父母，可他一旦落入马图拉女人那些甜言蜜语魔力的控制，并将他们的妩媚和害羞的微笑迷住，他甚至怎么能有可能回到我们这些单纯的乡村女孩的身边呢？
Text 25. When the Dasharas, Bojas, Andakas, Vrishnis, and Satvatas see the son of Devaki in Mathura, they will certainly enjoy a great festival for their eyes, as will all those who see him traveling along the road to the city. After all, he is the darling of the goddess of fortune and the reservoir of all transcendental qualities.
Dasarha, Bhoja, Andaka, Vaisani 和 Satvata 王朝的人看到 Devaki 之子在 Mathura 时，他们的眼睛必会享受一场盛大的节日，那些看到他在城市的街道上行进的人也不例外，毕竟他是幸运女神的爱人，是所有超然品质的保护。
Text 26. He who is doing this merciless deed should not be called Akrura. He is so extremely cruel that without even trying to console the sorrowful residents of Braja, he is taking away Krishna, who is more dear to us than life itself.
做出这种狠心事的人不应该被称为 Akrura， 他冷酷之至，甚至都不尝试安慰一下 Braja 悲伤的居民，就带走了比我们，也带走了我们比生命还珍重的 Krishna。
27. Hard-hearted Krishna has already mounted the chariot, and now the foolish cowherds are hurrying after him in their bullock carts. Even the elders are seeing nothing to stop him. Today fate is working against
him. 铁石心肠的 Krishna 已经登上了马车，愚蠢的牧牛郎现在正乘坐他们的牛车，急匆匆地紧随其后，就连长辈都不说一句挽留他的话。命运今天在与我们作对啊。
Purport. Srila Sridhar Swami reveals what the gopis thought. These foolish cowherd men and elders are not even trying to stop Krishna. Don't they realize they are committing suicide?They are helping Krishna go to Mathura, but they will have to come back to Vrindavan and will certainly die in his absence. The whole world has become nonsensical.
要知，徐勒·随达尔·斯瓦米揭示牧牛姑娘们的内心想法说，这些愚蠢的牧牛郎和长辈甚至不尝试阻止 Krishna， 他们难道没人知道他们是在自杀吗？他们帮助 Krishna 去马图拉，但自己将不得不重返文达文，必会因为他不在而死去，整个世界变得毫无意义了。
Om Jnana Dimarandasya Jnanchana Shalakaya Chakshurmi Kamyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Shri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavanscha Shri Rupa Sakrajatam Sahagana Ratunatam Vihantam SajivamSadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakamitamscha Hey Krishna Karna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Taptakanchana Kaurange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamadi Hare Priye Vanchakalpatarubhyascha
pa sindu pa eva cha patitanam pa manibyo vaishnavibyo namo namaha namaha om vishnu padaya krishna pristaya bhutale shrimati bhakti vedanta swami dinamine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Vishatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasati Gauravata Vinda Hare Krishna Hare
So we're hearing one of the most famous of all the leelas of Lord Krishna.
在这里我们看到了著名的 Krishna Leela 消失光之一。
It's one of the most emotional, one of the leelas which create the strongest emotions and feelings of love and attachment for Krishna.
这里看到了对 Krishna 那种依附的最强烈的那种爱的情感。
Because Krishna is leaving Vrindavan. He's leaving his mother, Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda, and there he's leaving all the gopis, and he's going to go to Mathura. And this scene is often shown in paintings, artists often illustrate it, it's often described in poetry.It's one of the very, very famous leelas of Lord Krishna.
这是在 Krishna 最重要的一个著名的消失光之一。这个人姑娘看，他们看到 Krishna 飞离那种像和毒药那种感觉。
So Krishna, of course, never leaves Vrindavan because Krishna always remains. He's always in Vrindavan.
当然了 ，Krishna 永远不离开 Vrindavan， 他永远居住在 Vrindavan。
Krishna, it is, the Acharyas tell us, Krishna hid himself within the hearts of the gopis.
因为他知道 Krishna 永远居住在牧牛姑娘的心中。
And Krishna who goes to Mathura is Vasudeva Krishna.
Krishna 去 Mathura 的时候是以他 Vasudeva 的形象去 Mathura。
Shamsundara Krishna remains in Vrindavan. He remains with his gopis, with all the Brajbasi people.
那个香麦熏点儿会上这个形象永远在稳当稳在跟牧牛姑娘和稳当稳的居民在一块儿。
It's Vasudeva Krishna who has to do, who does the killing of the demons, who's going to Mathura to kill cancer.
这个 Vasudeva 这个形象的 Krishna, 他得去 Mathura 去杀恶魔去杀 cancer.
Shamsundara Krishna remains here and there in Braja to keep, to satisfy the hearts of all the
所以那个香麦熏的 Krishna 他待在文达文去满足这些布拉加居民的内心
So Akrura has been sent by Kamsa to do this task
所以那个Akrura被 Kamsa 所派去完成这项任务
So the gopis they're very critical of Akrura they're saying this name is not proper
所以这个牧牛姑娘就对这个阿库拉特别的批评，使劲骂他：“你的名字名不符实啊！”
They say your name should be Krura, it shouldn't be Akrura, it should be Krura. Krura means cruel, and Akrura means not cruel.
你的名字应该不叫阿库拉，应该叫库拉。库拉是残忍的，你不是不残忍阿库拉，你应该叫库拉，太残忍了。
So,Akrura had been given this task by Kamsa. Kamsa, on the Ekadasi day, today is also Ekadasi, but Ekadasi in the month of Phalgun, Kamsa called for Akrura and requested him to do this.
这个Akrura是被 Kamsa 所派在艾卡达西那一天，今天是艾卡达西。在艾卡达西那一天，Kamsa 把Akrura叫来让他去 做这项任务。
Kamsa had been told by Narada Muni that the child who was going to kill him had already taken birth as the son of Vasudeva.
Narada Muni 告诉 Kamsa, 杀死你的人已经出生了，出生在 Devaki 的孩子。Vasudeva 的孩子。
And he was hiding in the home of Nanda Maharaj.
他被藏在了南达马哈拉吉的家中。
So Kamsa was very angry.
Kamsa 听后简直是气疯了。
And he immediately, first he called for Kesi demon, and he told Kesi, go to Vrindavan and kill that Krishna.
他首先把一个叫 Kesi 的恶魔叫来，说去文达文，把 Krishna 给我干掉。
Kamsa wanted to try one more demon.
完了，卡姆萨就想派更另外一个更恶魔。
So many of his demon friends have gone there and been killed by Krishna. He thought, let's try Kesi. Let Kesi try and kill him.
他曾经派过很多恶魔去杀 Krishna， 全让 Krishna 给干掉了。完了，他又想派这个开心魔去杀 Krishna。
And then there was also Vyomasura.
他又派了 Yoma 魔。
Yoma。
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 Vyomasura。
Vyoma was also killed in the afternoon before Krishna came to Vrindavan. Before Krishna came to Mathura, Krishna first of all killed the demon Vyoma.
在 Krishna 去 Mathura 之前的那个下午， Krishna 把这 Vyoma 的恶魔也给杀掉。
So, Akura came, he arrived in Vrindavan in the evening.
所以 Krishna, Akura 到 Vrindavan 的时候当然是傍晚了。
And he offered his...He was, of course, feeling so fortunate that, wow, Kamsa is so kind to me that he's sending me to Vrindavan to see Krishna.
那个阿库拉是怎么想？哎呀，我这次走了鸿运了，卡姆萨居然派我到 Vrindavan 来见 Krishna， 我太走运了。
Getting this opportunity, and when Akura comes there in Vrindavan, Krishna and Balaram they bow to Akura and they massage Akura's feet and they practically worship Akura.
但是 Akura 到 Vrindavan 的时候 ，Krishna 和 Balaram 见到他以后顶拜，完了呢给他按摩他的足，还是恰当的崇拜 Akura。
Because Akura is their uncle, right? Uncle Akura, so they respect the elders, Krishna.
因为阿库拉是 Krishna 的是叔叔还是舅舅，反正是他的长辈。
And Akura, he tells after Krishna and Balaram first of all inquire about everything, and then they want to know why you've come.What's your purpose?
对，当然了 ，Krishna Balarama 首先问了 Akura 一些所有的每件事都过一一的问候之后，就问他你来问他们的目的何在啊
？And then Akura tells Kamsa is inviting you to come. There's going to be a festival, the Dhanush Yagya.
这个 Akura 说 ，Kamsa 要邀请你来马苏拉，马上有个节日叫
Dhanush Yagya。
Danus
means a bow.
Danu 的意思弓。
And yagya, the sacrifice for the bow.
Yagya 是一个祭祀，对弓的一个祭祀。
There was a great bow there in Mathura.
因为在马图拉有个巨大的弓。
So Kamsa was planned. He had planned many different things for killing Krishna and Balaram.
其实 Kamsa 在利用这个节日设了很多计谋，要杀掉 Krishna 和 Balaram。
He told also the keeper of the elephant, there was a very demonic elephant called Kuvalayapida. And he told Kuvalayapida, and he told the person who takes care of that elephant, that you keep the elephant there at the gate there to the arena in Mathura.
所以他安排一个非常邪恶的一个大象叫
Kuvalayapida
一个大象，这个很大象很邪恶，他带人告人把这个大象放在这个门口。来了就准备杀。
And then he told also his wrestlers like Chanura and Mustika and Toshala and the other people. He had these many wrestlers who were also to be there, and he had a special wrestling arena constructed.
然后他又建造了一个摔跤场。 邀请了很多的摔跤手和 Mustika Tandula 就邀请这些大的摔跤手。
And he said, let Krishna and Balaram come, and with, we're having a festival, they also can take part in the wrestling contest.
华乐说了啊，我们举行个大的节日， Krishna and Balaram 肯定来，他也会参加这个摔跤的比赛。
So this way, Kamsa was planning for the death of Krishna and Balaram.
所以 Kamsa 就这么样安排的这么多的计划，想要杀死 Krishna 和 Balaram。
But Akrura, he's a great devotee.He knows that actually Kamsa's planning for his own death.
但是呢，阿库拉身为伟大的奉献者，他很清楚，康萨安排这些，实际上安排自己去死亡。
You know, he didn't come to Vrindavan thinking Krishna and Balaram are going to be killed.
他从来没想，他去文达文接 Krishna and Balaram 是为了他们死。
He knew this Kamsa is going to be killed.
他很门，他门清，知道Kamsa肯定死。
So Akrura comes here to Vrindavan, and when Krishna and Balaram hear about all this, they laugh. They think, "Oh, very good."
那个阿库拉来到这个文达曼，库桑巴拉拉玛一听这计划，他也笑啊，这安排挺好的，太美妙了。
We definitely want to come for the festival. Going to be a festival. We want to all. When we hear there's a festival, we all want to go.
哦，他俩说，这哥俩说，哦，我们也听说过这节日了，我们早就想去了，正好，我们去吧。
And the cowherd boys are also going too.
啊，那些牧牛童啊，那牧牛郎一说，哎，我们也去掺和掺和。
The gopis are not going.
牧牛姑娘不允许去。
They have to stay back and take care of the children and the cows and look after the Vrindavan.
那个为啥不能去？待
long for the evening to come when Krishna would come home.
他们就渴望傍晚早点来，为什么 ？Krishna 回来，他们好看见 Krishna.
So in the Shikshastikam, Lord Chaitanya has described for us his feeling of separation.
在主的八心归，主彩檀尼亚用了一个诗节描述了这种分离之情。
Yugaitam nimashena chakshusha pravrishayitam shunyayitam jagat sarvam govinda virahiname O Govinda, feeling your separation, I am considering one moment to be like 12 years or more.
O Govinda, 与你分离一刻更胜一季，我泪如雨泻，你不在，整个世界对你空虚。
So this is the mood of the gopis. This is the feeling of separation that just one moment is like so many years.
这就是牧牛姑娘们的心态，一刻更胜一季。
We know how the gopis were not happy with Brahma for his creation, that he created these eyes which blink.
他牧牛姑娘甚至抱怨了这个 Brahma 这个宇宙的创造者，创造的眼睛咋一闪一闪，眨不眨眼？
你看看。Because my eyes are blinking, I cannot see Krishna all the time.
因为眼睛一眨，我不可能时时能看到 Krishna.
What kind of creator is this? This guy is useless.
这个创造者什么东西，创造了一点用都没有。
Lousy eyes he's given us. We cannot tolerate this.
他们无法忍受这个眼睛一眨看不到 Krishna.
And so all the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all the followers.They cultivate this mood of separation from Krishna.
所有主彩檀尼亚的追随者都要培养这种分离之情。
As we've been hearing from the previous speakers, because the more we are feeling separation, then that will bring to union.
这以前那讲课人就说，我们越感到分离之情，越把我们连接在一起。
The more we're thinking of the absence of Krishna, then that Krishna will come back to us.
我们越体验到Krishna 这种临不在的时候，我们越能够 Krishna 越能够来到我们面前。
And when Krishna is leaving, then Krishna also is telling the gopis, "Don't worry, I'm coming back."
当 Krishna 离开文达文的时候，对牧牛姑娘说。休要担心，少要害怕，我还会回来的。
Now, in later on, we'll hear the story of the Shyamataka jewel.
后来我们听到一个故事叫Shyamataka 宝石的故事。
And it describes more about Akrura.
但你那个故事更多描述了 Akura。
Because we're hearing how the gopis are not happy with Akura。
而且我们在今天学的诗中看到牧牛姑娘对 Akura 不高兴了。
He took Krishna away.
他居然把 Krishna 给带走了。
He didn't even console the gopis. He didn't even tell them, "Oh, I'm sorry, and you know, I have to do my duty. You know, forgive me." He just came and asked Krishna to go and took Krishna. He didn't say anything.
他甚至不跟牧牛姑娘说一句话，也不商量一下。哎呀，实在对不起呀、啊，我们把 Krishna 带走了，这是我的职责。连这句话不说，上来就把 Krishna 给拿走了。
And he didn't even tell Mother Yashoda that I'm taking your son away. You know, we have something to do in Mathura. Please forgive me.
他甚至都不跟亚苏的妈妈说一声，哎呀，对不起啊，马图拉有一些节日，有点事儿，我得带库萨走。连这话都不说，就把库萨给。
Now the gopis are attached to Krishna, but Mother Yashoda also, she is very attached to Krishna as her son.
不仅牧牛姑娘依附库萨，亚苏的妈妈更依附库萨，因为那个是儿子。
When you ask these ladies here, you know,
我们问问有孩子的女士，你们依不依附你们的儿子？
How much they feel for their sons?
你看你们不依附你的儿子，有没有有儿子
？And when you have grandson, it's even more, right?
如果你有孙子的话，那更依附了，比儿子还依附。
But Akura comes and he takes Krishna.The acharyas comment why they didn't mention anything about Mother Yashoda here in this pastime.
现在acharya就开始讨论了，为什么在这个诗节中、这个故事中没有提到亚苏的妈妈
？So there's two explanations given.
有两种解释，这里没提到亚苏的妈妈。
One is Sukadeva Goswami who's telling this pastime. He's thinking so much about the gopis. He's so overwhelmed with the feelings of the gopis.That he just forgot about Mother Yashoda.
有一个解释就是苏卡德瓦戈斯瓦米在讲这个诗节的时候，完全沉浸在牧牛姑娘的那种情感当中，居然把亚苏的妈妈给忘了，所以他没讲。
And some other people say that Mother Yashoda was told by the other gopis that he's just going for a couple of days. He'll be back in 2 days.
那个应该解释中，有牧牛姑娘告诉亚苏的妈妈说：“别着急，他去两天，过两天就回来了，不用着急啊。”就快点走，
So Mother Yashoda was not too much worried.
所以亚苏的妈妈没有比牛姑娘更焦虑，她应该过两天啊，我这儿就回来了，她没。
But what we hear in this chapter, we hear about the feelings of the gopis. They're really feeling the pain, Krishna leaving.
所以在这个世界中特别描述的是牧牛姑娘那种心态，妈，库萨要离开我们，太痛苦了。
Where is he going? He's going to Mathura, and the women in Mathura are not like us village girls.
哎呀，他去哪知道吗？库萨去马祖了，马祖拉的女子跟我们村姑不一样啊。
Look at the man smiling, you know, and all these men they're sitting.
完了，一般男的到城里一听说，哎，到城里那男的高兴坏了，美滋滋的，要见城里的女子了。
Women in Mathura, you know, they've got class, you know. No, they're not cowherd girls, you know, collecting the cow dung every day.
那个在城里的姑娘跟乡村不一样，城里姑娘从来不收集牛粪。
So the gopis, they think Krishna goes to Mathura. When he sees those women in Mathura, he'll never come back to us.
好了，牧牛姑娘想 ，Krishna 一去马图拉，再看到马图拉城里的女子，他不会再回来了。
It's at Akura's fault. He's come here to take Krishna away from us.
全是Akura的错误。他来到这儿就把Krishna带离了我们。
So it said the gopis cursed Akura.
所以牧牛姑娘们诅咒了阿库拉。
And the result was, when Krishna was in Dwarka, there was one Shaimantaka jewel.
诅咒的结果是什么？奎萨在朵瓦卡的时候发生了那个
Shaimantaka
宝石的故事。
And that jewel was producing gold, a quantity of gold every day.
因为这个Shaimantaka宝石每天都产黄金。
And Satrajit, he had got this jewel. He'd been worshipping the sun god, and the sun god had given him this jewel.
这个 Satrajit 他崇拜太阳神，太阳神给了他这个宝石。
So, when everyone saw Satrajit with the jewel, they thought he was the sun god.
当那个萨特戒拿这个宝石的时候，人们一看，以为他是太阳神呢。
And it happened that because he had this jewel, he was killed.
因为有这个宝石，他就被杀了。
You have a lot of wealth, you attract thieves.
如果大家谁钱多、财富多的话，你吸引都是小偷和贼。
And so somebody came and they.And this person, one person came and there was a group of people who made a conspiracy and they came and they arranged the killing of Satrajit.
对，是不是一个人，是一伙人设了一个计谋，是阴谋诡计把他给杀了。
And two of the people who were involved in the conspiracy were devotees.
而这些人设这些阴谋诡计当中有两个人是奉献者。
One is Krita Varma.
也是 Krita Varma.
He had been associating with Kamsa, and he became influenced by Kamsa.
因为他跟 Kamsa 联谊交往，所以他就受 Kamsa 的影响。
And the other person was a Krura.
另外一个渗入圈这个计谋中人就是阿库拉。
Now Akura's he's our acharya in offering prayers to Krishna.
他可是向主 Krishna 供奉祷文的阿查尔亚。
Just like Sukadeva Goswami is perfect by chanting and Maharaj Pariksit by hearing, Akura.Perfection was in offering prayers.
就像苏格德瓦格斯瓦米通过讲述而得到完美，帕瑞西王通过聆听得到完美，而库拉是通过献祷文得到完美。
And we heard some of his prayers on his arrival in Mathura, his journey into from Mathura to Vrindavan.
我们看到阿库拉从马图拉去文达文的途中，他献的这些祷文。
And later on, we will hear also in a short while, we will hear more prayers from him.
对，我们再往后稍后这个时节，就能看到他献的一些祷文。
So, Krura is a great devotee, but he got involved in the killing of such.
所以阿库拉是这么伟大的奉献者，也被卷入了杀死萨特吉的这个阴谋当中。
And Satrajit is the father-in-law of Krishna.
而萨特吉是Krishna 的岳父大人。
Satrajit had a daughter, Satyabhama.
Satrajit 有个女儿叫 Satyabhama.
Satrajit had given Satyabhama to Krishna as a wife.
所以他把他的女儿嫁给了 Krishna 做妻子。
And so Satrajit was the father-in-law of Lord Krishna.
所以 Satrajit 是 Krishna 的岳父。
And when Satrajit was killed, then Lord Krishna.He has to take action because his wife heard her father had been murdered. She was upset.
但是 Krishna 一听说岳父被杀了， Krishna 得采取行动。为啥？他妻子一听父亲被杀了，肯定不开心嘛。
Krishna has to please. He has to satisfy his wife.
因为 Krishna 作为老公得满足妻子。
And Krishna's father-in-law is also like his guru.
因为那个岳父啊，也是他女婿的咕噜，也是 Krishna 的咕噜。
So Krishna comes to hunt after this person who had killed Satrajit.
所以 Krishna 就回来就追那个杀死 Satrajit 的人。
Srimad Bhagavatam describes how he knew Krishna was coming. He knew that Krishna was going to come and kill him. He came to Akrura, asked Akrura, "Please protect me, save me from Krishna."
然后这个萨特吉的一听说 Krishna 回来了，赶紧去找阿库拉说：“救命啊，保护我，不要让 Krishna 杀我，救救我！”
But Akura said, "I cannot save you from Krishna and Balaram. They're the supreme personalities of Godhead. They're responsible for the creation of this whole world. How can I protect you from them?"
这个阿库拉说了：“我怎么能救你呢？我救不了我自己，或者 Krishna Balaram 是这个宇宙的创造者，我怎么对此无能为力？
So Akura knew the identity of Lord Krishna.
因为 Akura 明白 Krishna 的身份。
But because the gopis were not happy with him, they cursed him. You took Krishna away from us.
因为阿库拉遭到了牧牛姑娘的诅咒，你把 Krishna 从我们身边给带走了。
So one result was he got involved in that conspiracy for the killing Satraj.
所以作为这个诅咒的结果，阿库拉被卷入了杀害那个萨特吉的这种阴谋当中。
And the second thing that happened to him was he had to leave Dwarka.
另外一个诅咒的结果是，他阿库拉不得不离开 Dwarka。
And he had to go and live in an inauspicious place. He had to go live in Varanasi.
Varanasi, 他就去了一个不吉祥的城市住，这是诅咒另外一个结果。叫瓦尔纳西这个地方去住，不吉祥的地儿。
Varanasi, devotees generally we don't much care to go there.
因为什么？因为奉献者根本就不关心，不在乎去瓦尔纳西去住。
That's a place for dying.
那是死亡之地。
They burn the bodies there.
因为那个地方是烧死尸的地方。
If you have only a few days to live, you go to Benares.
如果
If you only have a few days left to live,
如果你离开身体的前几天，你可以去那。完了死后身体一烧是吧
？Then it's convenient for the cremation.
因为死前去那儿，直接走后直接烧比较方便，烧尸体比较方便。
And it's, of course, it's also the place of.Mayavadis and Buddhists.
因为那个地方也是 Mayavadi 非人格主义者和佛教徒待的地儿。
So we don't. This was what happened to Akrura because he done this service for Kamsa.
因为这就是 Akrura 遭遇的结果，因为他给 Kamsa 做事带来的下场。
He was fortunate. He got to see Krishna. He got to touch Krishna.
他很幸运。他见到了 Krishna， 他能触摸到 Krishna， 他能碰 Krishna。
But he didn't please Krishna's devotees。
但他没有取悦 Krishna 的奉献者。
And because he didn't please Krishna's devotees, he had to leave Dwarka. He had to leave the holy place and go to Varanasi。
因为他的奉献者不高兴，他得不得不离开这个 Dwarka， 去到瓦尔纳西去住。
So we have to be very careful not to be like Akrura。
大家小心了，千万别像杜阿卡那个阿库拉那样。
We want to cultivate this feeling of separation from Krishna. The mood of the gopis is vipralamba seva, service in the mood of separation.
所以我们大家要培养这种分离的这种心态，要像牧牛姑娘那种心态，叫 vipralamba seva， 在分离中的服务，要培养这个。
The Goswamis of Vrindavan.That they were always absorbed in the mood of the gopis.
Vrindavan 的那哥斯瓦米们经常沉浸在牧牛姑娘的心态当中。
The mood of the gopis is service to Krishna in the mood of separation from Krishna.
牧牛姑娘的心态是在于 Krishna 的分离之中去服务 Krishna.
We hear about the Goswamis how they're.Oh, where is Krishna? Is he over by the banks of the Yamuna? Is he on the Govardhan Hill? Where is he?
这个文达文的牧牛哥斯瓦米们经常在想 ，Krishna 你在哪儿？你在亚穆纳河畔吗？你在哥瓦丹山脚下吗
？We read about the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he resided in Jagannath Puri. How he felt the same mood of separation.
我们看柴丹亚马巴布在加格纳的普瑞的所经常引述的一个祷文，就处在这种分离的这种情感中。
He would see the sea at Jagannath Puri, and the sea is very blue there, and he would think it's the Yamuna River. He'd run into the sea. Where is Krishna?
所以柴丹亚在加格纳普瑞走这个加纳的时候，他有那种心态，他见到那个河的时候，他以为是亚穆纳河，就直接奔过去 ，Krishna 那在哪儿？
And there's another hill also there beside the Jagannath Puri temple. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would think it's Govardhan. He would go running towards it.
然后呢，在加纳普里附近呢，还有一些小山，就是柴丹亚马哈普以为那些山就是那个哥瓦尔丹山，就直接奔过去。
When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had gone to Gaya and taken initiation, he came back through Kanai Natsala.
他三年去嘎雅得到启迪， 然后
they came back to a place on the way to back home to Navadvip from Gaya. He passed, came into a place called Kanai Natsala.
对，有个地方叫 Kanai Natsala， 就从 Gaya 返回拿了推拐的途中都经过这个地方。
We have a temple there. We have no one else.
我们在那儿有我们的庙。
It's a very very special holy place.
那个是一个非常特殊的一个圣地。
And it's right on the bank of the Ganga.
在恒河的岸边。
And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was there, he saw Krishna.
当彩泰尼亚在那个圣地的时候，他见到了 Krishna.
Krishna had appeared to him and then ran away.
Krishna 在他面前一显现之后就跑了。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was feeling the separation from Krishna.
所以彩泰尼亚马哈帕布就体验到与 Krishna 那种分离的情感。
So when he came back to Navadvip, he met with Gadadhar, and he was asking Gadadhar, "Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna?"
然后马哈帕布呢回到了这 Navadvip， 见到了 Gadadhar， 就问 Krishna 在哪儿 ？Krishna 在哪儿？
Gadadhar said, "He's in your heart. Don't worry. He's in your heart."
好嘞，Gadadhar说。别着急，在你心中，会想在你心中。
Then Lord Chaitanya took his nails and began to rip, tried to rip open his chest.
然后彩檀尼亚就他那个手指甲，就开始挖他的心，挖自己的心，要拔出。
Because he was so much anxious to find Krishna.
他是如此的焦虑的、焦急的，想要看到 Krishna 本人。
And Gadadhar, in the mood of Srimati Radharani, took the hands of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and told him.Don't worry, he's coming just now.
那个嘎达达尔是住在徐马提罗拉乱的心态，就抓他说别着急 ，Krishna 就来了，现在就来了。
We read also, just like we're hearing here, how the gopis are angry, showing some anger feelings to Krishna that you're leaving us. How you can go away and leave us?
对，我们今天学的师姐就描述了牧牛姑娘们怀那种愤怒的。这种心态呀、啊，就是说，奎萨，你怎么狠心离开了我们呢
？So in the same way, Srimati Radharani spoke to the bumblebee.
同样 ，Srimati Radharani 对那个大黄蜂的那个对话。
Uddhava had come with a message from Krishna.
乌达瓦来问他们给奎萨捎信儿。
And Radharani began to speak to the bumblebee.
Radharani 开始跟大黄蜂说话。
And she told the bumblebee, "Don't you come near me."You're the unreliable servant of an unreliable master.
Reliable.
Unreliable.
不可靠。
不可靠的。他就跟大黄蜂说，别靠近我，离我远点，你是不可靠的主人。
You're unreliable servant of an unreliable master.
你是不可靠的仆，主人的不可靠的仆人。
I know everything about you. I know you're just like your master.
我对你是太了解了，门清。你跟你的主人一个德行。
You have the same nature as your master.
你跟你的主人的本性一个味儿。
Just like the bumblebee comes and takes some honey from the flower, then goes to another flower.
就像大黄蜂来到一朵花面前，采完蜜了就离开这个花，去到另一个花去采蜜去。
And the same way your master came to us, and he enjoyed with us.And now he's gone to other women.
你的主人呢？来到我们这儿，享受了我们以后，又去找别的女的了。
And left us with a broken heart.
你一离开我们，让我们心碎了。
I don't want anything more to do with you.
我不想再跟你有任何关系了。
And then the bumblebee disappeared from the vision.
说完这话，大黄蜂唰没了，消失了。
And then Radharani became frantic.Oh, where did you go? Oh, maybe you've gone to tell Krishna what I said.
然后Radharani就开始懵了。哎呀，你去哪了？你是不是回到Krishna面前，把我刚才说的话都告诉Krishna？
Oh no, please don't go and tell Krishna.
哦，可千万别回去告诉Krishna我说的话呀。
You will never come back to me.
你这么一说，Krishna再也不回到我的身边了。
And then the bumblebee reappears again.
刚说完。咔嚓，大黄蜂又显现了。
And then Radharani said, "Oh, again you have come."
哎呀，Radharani说，哎呀，你终于又回来了。
So in this way, this is the mood of the gopis, and of all the gopis, the one with the highest love for Krishna is Srimati Radharani.
所以这就是牧牛姑娘的情感，而且这个牧牛姑娘最高的这种情感展现的是Srimati Radharani.
There are different feelings of ecstatic love for Krishna.
这是对 Krishna 爱的不同的极乐狂喜的展示。
And of all these different gopis, it is Srimati Radharani who has the greatest feeling of love.
而这个所有牧娘姑娘当中，这个Srimati Radharani 是最高的爱的一种展示。
She cannot tolerate even a moment without.
他甚至与 Krishna 分离，没有 Krishna 这片刻都忍受不了。
Said one time she was with Krishna, and a bumblebee appeared, and the bumblebee is called Madhu.
这个大黄蜂叫 Madhu， 他跟 Krishna 在一起的时候，见到一个大黄蜂显现。
So the bumblebee came, and you know, a bee comes, you go.You know, you become a little worried that maybe they'll sting me.
对，当我们看到大黄蜂向我们飞来的时候，我们大家会有点害怕，生怕这个黄蜂会叮我们。
So Radharani was sitting with Krishna when the bee came, and then they chased the bee away. Krishna chased the bee away.
当 Radharani 跟 Krishna 坐在一块的时候，这个黄蜂来的时候 ，Krishna 就撵就拍打这些。
Then he said, "Madhu's gone."
完了就说，完了说，因为这大黄蜂叫 Madhu 嘛，他们说 Madhu 走了。
And then when Radharani heard Madhu gone, because Krishna is also known as Madhu Sudan, he's also called Madhu. So when Krishna, Madhu's gone, oh no, Krishna's left me, oh no.
因为 Krishna 他也叫 Madhu Sudan 的嘛，所以 Radharani 一听 Krishna 说 Madhu 走了， Radharani 就不 Krishna 走了哦。
Although Krishna was right there with her, just hearing that Krishna is gone broke Radharani's heart.
当时 Krishna 虽然坐在旁边， Radharani 一听 Madhu Krishna 走了， Radharani 就受不了了。
This is the feelings of love which the gopis have for Krishna.
这就是牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的爱的展示。
They don't have to study philosophy or practice brahmachari life to develop love for Krishna.
他们牧牛姑娘们可没研习哲学，牧牛姑娘们可没当什么真修生来培养对 Krishna 爱。
They're simple village girls.
他们只是简单的村姑。
And they just only love Krishna.
但他们拥有对 Krishna 至高的爱。
And so the thought that Krishna is leaving them.Very
只是想到 Krishna 要离开他们，简直是痛苦不堪的。
It is not a, this is hearing this pastime is not very pleasing to the devotees.
奉献者一听到这个消失光，奉献者都不是那么太开心。
Just like you'll notice, we don't hear about how Krishna leaves the world. Also, it's not described in this 10th canto.
所以像在第十篇里面没有更多描述 Krishna 离开这个世界的这个情景。
And we don't hear about Lord Chaitanya leaving the world.
我们也没有听到主彩檀尼亚怎么离开这个世界的一些细节。
Because he thinks they're so painful for them.
因为一听到这些细节，简直是没法活了。
So in the same way, Krishna leaving Vrindavan is also very.
同样 ，Krishna 离开 Vrindavan 也是令人痛苦的。
Okay, any question?
那个，我们与灵性导师这种分离的情感，是不是也应该培养 ？We plant a seed 吧，我们。
Well, we are told, and he's asking, should we have the same feeling for separation from the spiritual master? We're told there's two ways to associate with the spiritual master. There's vanu.The vani and the vapu, the physical body and the instruction.
我们被提到与林老师交往有两种，一个是 vapu， 一个是 vani。
And we have to learn to associate with the spiritual master through the instructions. It's more important than the body.
我们要学会这个与灵性导师联谊呢，通过他的训示，比他这个服他的身体更重要。
The body is not eternal, but the instructions are eternal.
身体不是永恒的，训示是永恒的。
Just as Arjuna had to also learn to associate with Krishna after Krishna departed from the world, Arjuna had to remember Krishna's instructions.
所以这个 Arjuna 也得学会什么呢？ Krishna 离开这个世界以后，他得学习怎么记忆 Krishna， 通过记忆他的训示。
And after Krishna left Vrindavan, he sent Balaram back to Vrindavan, and then he sent Uddhava back to Vrindavan, and both of them were instructing the gopis in how to cultivate that mood of feeling for Krishna.
这个 Krishna 离开文大文之后，他派了巴拉拉玛来，派了乌达瓦来，他这两个人都要去教导的那样的牧牛姑娘如何学习这种服务的这种心态。
Actually, Uddhava, he was a disciple of Brihaspati and he knew all the philosophy, but Krishna sent him to Vrindavan to learn from the gopis.
其实啊，这个乌达瓦是 Brihaspati 的门徒，他精通哲学，但 Krishna 派他去的目的是让他去Vrindavan，从牧牛姑娘那里去学习。
Yeah, because when Uddhava came to Vrindavan and saw how much love the gopis have for Krishna.
哎，乌达瓦一去Vrindavan一看，哎呀，这牧牛姑娘爱 Krishna 怎么那么爱的死去活来呢？
Then Uddhava prayed, "Let me take birth as a plant or a blade of grass in Vrindavan."
完了，乌达瓦就祈祷，让我投身在Vrindavan的地上的一根小草吧。
Then I can get the dust from the feet of the gopis.
这样我就能得到牧牛姑娘莲花足下的尘土了。
They will never let me take the dust of their feet. They will not allow me to take.
因为我不这样做，他们绝不允许把他们的莲花足的尘土放在我头上。
But if I become a plant or grass, then I can get the dust.
但如果我投身在本达文的一个小草的话，他们就可以把他们的尘土放在我的头上。
Anudava.Coming there, then he encouraged the gopis also to remember all of Krishna's pastimes. And they would reenact how Krishna performed all his different lilas. How he killed the different demons. And how he picked up Govardhan. All of these different realms, and in this way, they would feel the presence of Krishna.
这个他们就是这样畅饮昆山不同的消失光，跟昆山愉悦的消失光。
Just like we remember Prabhupada by hearing Prabhupada's pastimes.
就像我们通过聆听帕帕德的消失光来那个喝饮帕帕一样，记忆帕帕一样。
Encourage all the devotees to read Prabhupada, Lilamrita, and some of the other books written by people who have written books about Prabhupada.
我们就是鼓励大家要读这个《学了泡泡的 Lilamrita》，有关泡泡的这个消失光。
We hear about Prabhupada, we remember Prabhupada.
聆听泡泡，记忆泡泡。
It's like being with Prabhupada.
这样就和泡泡在一起了。
So the same way, we hear about Krishna's pastimes, we're also with.
同样记住奎山的消失光，我们就和奎山在一起了。
So we associate with the spiritual master through the instruction.
所以我们通过执行灵性导师的训示来，跟林老师在一起。
In the chapter 10, it teaches the highest love of Krishna. And as you say, it's not.So it's completely contradictory to the loving exchange that we have in this material world, where if the husband were to look for another lady, completely the wife will straight away divorce. So why Krishna has to teach the kind of love which is so much contradictory to what we learn here in this world?
他大概意思说，在第十章这个。第十篇描述的是最高的爱，完了呢，在物质层面上就是，如果一个男的啊找个小三之类的，完了跟他妻子离婚，就找另外女的是不合法的。但库上在这里展示什么呢？他去找另外女的，他这个是不是相矛盾？哎，
嗯。Well, this is the pure love of the gopis.
但这里描述的是牧牛姑娘纯粹的爱。
The love of the spiritual world.Is much higher on a much higher level than the love of the material world.
灵性世界这个爱呀、啊，灵性世界的爱情和物质世界的所谓爱情不在一个层面，是更高的层面。
Mm-hmm. So just like the final verse of Shikshastikam, Krishna is described as Lampata, you know, a womanizer, a man who has many women, runs after women.
就像那个主的八星堆 的最后一条这里提到了，就是有很多女子的，拥有很多女子的人。
You make me broken hearted.
你拥有那么多，你让我心碎。
But still, you're my Lord unconditionally.
但你仍然是我无条件的主。
So unconditional love is there in the spiritual world.
只有在灵性世界才有无条件的爱情。
Material world is conditional love.
物质世界是有条件的爱情。
You love me. You don't love anybody else.
你只许爱我，不许爱别人。
Okay, Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam ki
Jai, Prabhupada ki Jai.